SS Shivani with Mr. Vivek Gupta, who is a very famous career counselor in education field. And today we are discussing about Tashkent Medical Academy, Uzbekistan. So sir, tell me about Tashkent Medical Academy. What are the advantages and disadvantages of doing MBBS for an Indian student specifically?
Okay. Shivani, Tashkent Medical Academy is a 100-year-old government university, and as the name suggests, it's right in the capital of Tashkent, Uzbekistan, which is Tashkent, and it is named as Tashkent Medical Academy, which actually tells you broadly about the credentials. So it's like, you know, you have India University, if something is named like that. So it's the kind of credentials, the kind of government backing that this university enjoys. It's by far it's the number one university of MBBS in Uzbekistan. So as far as quality of education is concerned, curriculum is concerned, history is concerned, vintage is concerned, experience is concerned, there is no doubt, there is no questions asked. Now comes, especially for Indian students, what we look at, and that is where we compare advantages and disadvantages. Right? So when I generally counsel students who come to me for MBBS abroad or in general, we have 12 to 13 countries, as you know, and about 50 universities to choose from. There are 6-7 famous criteria that I always look for people to check. One is definitely whether it is a government university or a privately owned university. It is a government owned university. Secondly, is how old the university is, which means how much experience does it have to teach students who pass from the college and have a successful career. It's a 100-year-old university. So they have passed out more than 95 batches and must have made thousands of doctors.
That is also a very big advantage.
Big advantage, right?
Exactly.
So tenure is there's no problem. Now, especially for India, when we go abroad, as you know, India course is 4.5 years plus 1 year of internship. So total we spend 5.5 years. And when we go abroad, there are few countries who follow 6 years of education, like Russia, Ukraine. Then there is Nepal, which follows exactly Indian system of education. And then there are some countries who follow 5 years of education. So Uzbekistan once again falls into 5 years of education, which means you can finish your course in 5 years, which means you save 1 year. So third aspect, tenure of the course is once again for our advantage. Now the fourth thing is how far it is from India. Is it really far away? You have to change couple of flights, 3 flights. How much time it will take? Would it take you 16 hours of travel time, 18 hours of travel time? Is my fourth criteria. Once again, this university have only got a 3-hour flight straight from Delhi, Mumbai, which means if you have to rush back for any urgent thing at home, or if your family members have to visit you, they can just have to catch a 3-hour flight, which is as good as Delhi to Trivandrum flight. So the travel time is also on the positive side. As a level of education, history, travel time, tenure of the course, all are in favor. Then the fifth thing is availability of food. So very frankly, there has been a very recent development, especially for the entire Uzbekistan, and this university gets a very important thing out of it, that historically Uzbekistan, or even today, they have their own country entrance exam to allocate MBBS seats, the way Nepal has. And that's why many of the Indian students may not have been going there in the past. But now they have recently decided and announced that they will accept NEET qualified students as a student who have qualified their own entrance exam. Earlier that was not the criteria. So because of the mandation of NEET qualification, Uzbekistan as a country have also agreed that we are happy to now take the Indian student directly, or international students for that matter, without their entrance exam, because of that you are now not anybody, but you are still at least NEET qualified. But they want to take only quality students. So the fifth factor is now, so what they are doing, they have allocated a hostel dedicated for Indian students. They have allocated 100 seats, as we know, for Indian students. And there are separate sections of boys and girls in those hostel, in that hostel. And incidentally, the hostel is named along with our second Prime Minister of India, Mr. Lal Bahadur Shastri ji. So the hostel is actually named on the name of Lal Bahadur Shastri. And just to again share with the audience and you, it was an unfortunate thing, but just to share, so that we understand the emotional connection that we have with this country and the city in particular, not as I said with this college. That is the same city where we lost Lal Bahadur Shastri, who was still cherished to be the best Prime Minister or the most loved Prime Minister India ever had. So he has gone to Tashkent to sign that famous Tashkent Treaty, and that is where we lost him. So Indian connection with Tashkent actually goes back till to 1960s, right? And Indians have been going to Tashkent, and just think why Tashkent would have been chosen as a neutral place for India and Pakistan to go and meet. So that is the cultural heritage, that is the emotional connection that we have with Tashkent. And that is why that particular university is happy to name our hostel basis of Mr. Shastri ji. They have allocated and they are hiring Indian cooks because they have allocated 100 seats. So it must make economic sense for 100 students to have a dedicated Indian mess. So the fifth criteria about the hostel and the sixth criteria about the food is both taken care of. So very frankly, of course, it's MCA approved. So that is the seventh thing. So if I look at the advantages list and in my criteria of selection,
this is going to be so big right now.
It is like 100 out of 100.
Exactly.
Very frankly, even the weather is pleasant.
Yes.
So unlike most of the CIS countries, which are slightly on the colder side, as you know, you get snowfall 6 months in a year in Russia, Uzbekistan is exactly following the Delhi weather with a slightly better thing. So the maximum temperature is 30 degrees, the minimum is minus 5, which means you are not shivering in minus 30 and you are not frying up in 45.
Okay.
So even the weather is also good. So still, if I have to select a disadvantage, which I'm thinking very thoroughly, I think the only disadvantage that we together can think of is that because of this entrance exam rule, in the last 3-4-5 years, not many Indian students are going there. Not many. In the last 3-4 years. So that is a difference that we surely have in terms of number of students. So you parents might see or students might see, if they look at the last 3-4 years number, that not many students have gone there. So the recent experience of Indian students going to that college may not be that much available. So if somebody is looking at, you know, I want to see the reference of the last year, the last 2 years, I think that is something where this entire Uzbekistan in whole and this college in particular might be feeling some bit of disadvantage, that this college cannot offer you the last 3 years testimonials. But having said that, if you Google it, when India and Russia were really close friend 30 years back, 40 years back, then there used to be Indian sponsored student who used to go and study in Russian countries. I'm talking about 1980s and 90s when Russia was not Russia and they all were under USSR. That time, Tashkent Medical Academy was actually one of the chosen universities where Indian students was going and studying on government scholarship. So that is the history. So as I said, I think the only disadvantage which I can think of is no testimonial for the last 2-3 years in particular. But other than that, if you go by the scale of criteria, it scores best in almost all of the criteria.
Okay, sir. So I would like to ask one more question, sir. As we have heard about many countries related to the medical course, like Ukraine, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, and China, but we haven't heard about more about Uzbekistan and all. So could you please elaborate Tashkent Medical Academy?
Yes. See, just to I will answer your question in both parts. So why Uzbekistan was not heard, as we just mentioned, like USA, Canada, Australia, Uzbekistan have their own entrance exam. So when students approach consultants, and consultants know that you have to go there and actually appear in an entrance exam, and if you fail in there, you have to come back. So we may not suggest to that university or college, or country for that matter. Because the entire Uzbekistan have got the entrance exam. It's like Nepal, where you know colleges and their own university have entrance exam. So if you ask me, I send you under Tribhuvan University, you first have to appear in the entrance exam, it's very confusing.
Mm-hmm.
So the better thing is, just go to another country. So because of the entrance exam, which is on one side is very positive, so those countries, that particular country and these institutes, including Tashkent Medical Academy, doesn't want to take any or every student. So they wanted only quality students. They have a certain criteria that we will take their own entrance exam, because NEET was not mandatory in India. People were not even taking NEET, so people were approaching without even appearing in NEET with the 52% class 12th marks. Uzbekistan doesn't need those students. As you know, China also doesn't take students more than less than 70% marks in PCB. And this year, after NEET, they have made a rule, no student with less than 200 marks in NEET. Same way, Uzbekistan also carries the same quality, and Tashkent Medical Academy in particular. So even today, they have said, we will take students which are at least NEET qualified, which means 134 marks and more. So that's why you haven't heard much about this particular option, because they were not very, very open to take just any student. They wanted to take quality student. Till last year, there was no measurement of quality. This year, the measurement of quality has come in terms of NEET, and that's why they're happy to open. Should I say, this year, Uzbekistan have opened their doors for us. And Tashkent Medical Academy in particular have opened its door for us.
For all the international candidates, not just yes, for
yes, 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 yes.
All right, sir.
So that is the reason that now you will hear its
from,
name
from this
much
year
more. Words. Much all more. Right, much
sir. Okay, sir. But what about the fee structure, or how much it will cost for an Indian student or an international student?
I think we missed that point when we were discussing both criteria.
Exactly.
So once again, the total package is about 21-22 lakh rupees when you convert it to Indian rupees. So, is it the cheapest option available for Indian students? Maybe no. As you know, there are a few universities in Kyrgyzstan which can give you 18-19.
Yeah.
So, it is slightly 2 lakh rupees expensive than that, or about 8%. But for majority of the universities, if, you know, the 150 universities that we talk about, which are available for Indian students, its cost is in the bottom 10. Not the bottom most, but in the bottom 10. So, as far as cost is concerned, it is very, very affordable for majority of the population.
This is also going to be very cheap if the student is going to pursue MBBS, because that costs a lot of amount. If I talk about Nepal and China, that costs...
Yes, yes, sir. Nepal is over 60 lakh rupees,
yes,
as you know.
Yes.
China is also, the entire package is about 30 lakh.
Mm-hmm.
But this country, you finish it in 21-22.
That is also going to be a great deal for any of the students.
That's what I'm saying. I think with the announcement of this waiving of the test, as we are talking, and as the news will be spread across India, I don't know by the end of this video, we have any seats left for Uzbekistan or not, honestly speaking, or this particular university that we're talking about in particular, because the rule has come 3 days back that NEET is now accepted as an entrance exam for these universities. As I told you, I think there are 3 universities in total in Uzbekistan which are open for Indian students. Tashkent Medical Academy is top most of them. It has got only 100 seats. So I really don't know, by the time we finish this video, or by the time we finish this week, or maximum by the time we finish this fortnight, I don't think the students will get seats beyond July end to this university. So if you are re-qualified, if you are more than 60% PCB, I think just rush to your nearest trusted MBBS consultant and look for this university. You will be happy in future.
Alright sir, thank you so much for this information, and I would like to suggest people, if you are considering a good medical or good MBBS country, then consider Uzbekistan. And if you have more queries, then you can definitely consult Mr. Vivek Gupta as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a nice day.